hits, three runs, all earned. He had one walk and had eight strikeouts on Monday night. So John Strotka getting the start here tonight for the Explorers. He's just completing his warm-up tosses. The Explorers tonight in the multicolored jersey with the red and the black sleeves with the white piping on the shoulders, and Wichita in that camouflage top tonight with the red numerals and the gray pants. So we're about ready to go with baseball. Glad you could have joined us here on a Saturday night in Sioux City for Explorers Baseball as Nick Van Stratton will step in to lead it off for the Wingnuts. Van Stratton, 375 average, two hits, six at-bats, and a doubleheader last night, right-handed hitter. And Strotka's first pitch is in there for a strike, and we are underway at 7:06 Central Daylight Time on this Saturday. We'll set the Explorers defensively for you in a moment, a little bit different. Foul back by Van Stratton, and it's no balls, two strikes. Eno Patron has been activated as the Explorers can go to 23 men on the roster. So Patron has been working out for the ball club. He'll play first base tonight. And you have Rene Tassoni playing second base. Rest of the infield, Perillo is at short. Mendoza is at third base. No balls, two strikes on Van Stratton. Takes it high for a ball. The outfield, Keys is in left. Johnson in center, Lang in right. And Matt Coach doing the catching. One ball and two strikes on Van Stratton. The 1-2 pitch in the dirt, blocked by Matt Coach. And it evens it up at two balls and two strikes. Strotka is making his 19th start of the year. He has pitched 118 and a third innings this season. He has struck out 96. He has walked 31. The right-hander set. Hit down the right field line, but foul. That will be down toward the Wichita bullpen down in the right field corner. Explorers have Keys in left, Johnson in center, Lang in right. On a very comfortable Saturday evening, a little bit warmer than it was here last night. It got mighty chilly. 2-2 pitch. Hit in the air. Left center field. Going out is Perillo. Coming in is the left fielder Keys, and he reaches down about the knees to make the catch for the out. So Van Stratton flies out to Keys in left field to start it off here in the top of the first inning for Jace Ray. Ray on a four-game hitting streak. He was 2-for-3 in the doubleheader last night. Left-handed hitter comes in at 307 average with one home run and 33 RBIs. Mendoza at third will play up about even with a bag. Step behind the bag at first is Patron, and a first pitch strike to the left-handed hitting Ray. So John Strotka with a record of 10 wins and 2 losses. The Explorers have three pitchers that are in double-digit wins this year. And the 0-1 pitch coming. Low and inside, and it's a ball and a strike. Of course, Patrick Johnson became the first 14-game winner with a win last night. And then in the second game, it was Zimmerman picking up his 13th win of the year. 1-1 pitch. Foul back and off to our left, and that will whistle out of the ballpark. Foul ball, strike two. 1 ball, two strikes. And then you have Strotka with 10 wins coming into tonight's game. So the Explorers have three pitchers on the staff that has 10 wins or more. And that shows you why this ball club has won the Central Division and have a record of 69 wins coming into tonight's game. 1-2 pitch. It's lined into center field for a base hit. So Ray with a line drive center, actually to left center field, to extend his hitting streak to 5 games. Wichita had problems at the plate last night. A lot of that has to do with the pitching, or most of it does. They only had 2 hits in the second game last night. They did have 6 hits in the first game, but the Explorers, in last night's doubleheader win, just went on a tear as far as the two big innings in each of those 2 games. This is Brent Cleveland, the designated hitter, right-handed hitter. He went 0-for-5 last night, playing in his 4th game. With Wichita. They have added some new players, and of course last night at midnight was the last time that you could add new players before the playoffs begin. Cleveland looks at a strike. I understand the only time that you can add any players between now and the end of the season would be a rookie catcher. You could sign a rookie catcher, but no one else. No balls and one strike on Cleveland. Ray at first base. He's had 16 stolen bases. And he will attract the throw over to first and back without a tag. Eno Patron being reactivated today, I guess is the best way to put it, because he was with the ball club during spring training, was released, got picked up again by the Explorers, was released again, and now is picked up. One ball and one strike on Cleveland. Down and away with a breaking pitch, and it's one ball and one strike. A little bit of a breeze we have tonight is blowing out of the south-southeast or the east-southeast at about 6 miles an hour. A little bit of a breeze from the right field corner out toward left field. Not like the north wind we had last night. 1-1 pitch. It's over but low. And it's two balls and one strike on Cleveland. One out, runner at first, no score. We're just underway here in the top of the first inning. And tonight is the 2015 Sioux City Explorers baseball card set giveaway night. And of course, players will be available after the game for post-game autographs. Stretch by Strotka. Long pause to the plate. Foul back to the screen. Two balls and two strikes on Cleveland. Colbert has three balls, two strikes. Should be two and two, I believe. Two balls and two strikes on Cleveland. Over at first base is Ray, has right at a two-step lead. Strike is delivery. Down and away, and now it's a full count of three balls and two strikes. Well, let's see if Ray will be running on this 3-2 pitch with one out. He has 16 stolen bases on the season in 24 attempts. Explorers infield, a double play depth. Strotka pauses right at the letters. There goes the runner, and the pitch is down low, ball four. So that'll put runners at first and second with one out. So a single by Ray and a walk to Cleveland puts runners at first and second for Wichita. Andy LaRoche coming up. He was 1-for-4 last night. Comes in hitting a 279. Five home runs, 16 RBIs. LaRoche, 4 out of 4 hits in his last 15 at-bats. He's a right-handed hitter. So Wichita with a threat early. Runners first and second with one out. Pitch into the dirt. Now coach can't find it. When he does, over to third base without a throw. That'll be a wild pitch charged on Strotka. Pitch in the dirt. The runner at first base, Cleveland, stayed there. He did not move, but actually the runner at second, Ray, kind of hesitated at first, and then when Matt Coach couldn't find the pitch, he took off and went to third without a throw. So it's first and third with one out, no balls, one strike. Should be one ball and no strikes. Here's a line drive toward left field down the line. It is a foul ball. And that ball down on the barbecue deck. And it's one ball and one strike on Andy LaRoche. LaRoche hitting at 279. Five home runs, 16 RBIs. One ball and one strike on LaRoche. We turned on that one. Runners first and third, one out. Strotka ready to the plate. Swing and a miss, strike two. So it's one ball and two strikes. The manual scoreboard is not operating too good right now. Should be one ball and two strikes on LaRoche. Runners first and third, Strotka from the stretch, here's the pitch. tap right in front of the plate. That may be an out. I see. He is out. That's right. Good call by the home plate umpire, Steve Shore. The ball hit into fair territory, and the ball hit LaRoche while he was in fair territory. Here comes Kevin Hooper down, the manager for Wichita. Steve Linton, the crew chief, is coming down from first base, and they will discuss it here. But the home plate umpire, Scott Shore, said he hit him in fair territory. Now the all three umpires, it is an out. So the three umpires have agreed, and that will be a catcher's unassisted putout. And that's the second out of the inning. He hit the ball, bounced in front of the plate, and it actually bounced up and hit the hitter, LaRoche. And if it hits a runner or a hitter in fair territory, you're out. And that's the call. And now it's D.J. Mittelstadt, left-handed hitter, with two outs and runners first and third. Mittelstadt takes a strike. Mittelstadt was 0-for-5 last night in the doubleheader, hitting a .257. 14 home runs, though, 61 RBIs. He has had 8 hits in his last 19 at-bats. Stratka, the right-hander, on the hill for the Explorers. To the plate. Swing and a miss. Took a little bit off of it. Almost a straight change. And Mittelstadt had a big cut at it. Came up empty. And it's no balls and two strikes on T.J. Mittelstadt. It was Perillo stepped up in front of the bag, took the cutoff, and threw back to the plate to get Ray for the final out here in the first inning. Here in the first for Wichita. No runs, one hit, no errors, and they leave one. Our score after a half inning. It's Wichita nothing, and the Explorers are coming to bat on KSCJ. On the mound tonight for Wichita is right-hander Scott Richmond. Leading it off, Matty Johnson for the Explorers. Shows bunt and takes it high for ball one. Matty Johnson went 5-for-8 in the doubleheader last night, including 3 doubles. Left-handed hitter against the right-hander Richmond, who misses inside, and it's 2-0. Scott Richmond, boy, you're talking about a guy that's had a long story of places where he has played. Here's a ball hit toward left field. On the run is Ray, and he makes the running catch toward the barbecue deck in left field. So Matty Johnson is the first out here in the bottom of the first inning. Scott Richmond will be 36 years old tomorrow. Played at Missouri Valley College for 1 year. Bossier Parish Community College in Bossier, Louisiana for 1 year, and then went to Oklahoma State where he finished his career. Had some time in the big leagues. Here's Michael Lang. Hits an in the air down the right field line, and it's giving chase and diving and can't get it in foul territory is Kane. Blue Jays in 2007. Before that, he was not signed and spent one season in an amateur summer league in Western Canada. Worked on the dockyards in Vancouver for a summer. Made his major league debut in 2008. No balls, one strike on Lang. Down and away for a ball. Started out his professional career in the Northern League in 2005, 06, and 07. He pitched at Edmonton. The 1-1 pitch, Lang lines it foul off the right side down into the bleachers, and it's one ball and two strikes. Really, his best year in Edmonton was 07, where he had a record of 10-9. Then he was signed as a free agent by the Blue Jays. 2008, pitched with New Hampshire in the Eastern League. He was 5-8 there. Then at Syracuse in the International League, he was 1-3. Lang takes it down low and outside, and it's two balls, two strikes, and he made his debut in the major leagues in 2008 with the Blue Jays, and he had a record of 1-3. Two balls, two strikes on Lang. Hits it toward right center field and caught by the center fielder Van Stratton. Boy, he got a great break on it and took off and made the running grab for the second out here in the first inning. So two out, Rene Tassone, who had three hits, four at bats in the doubleheader last night. 248 average, two home runs, 53 RBIs. But Richmond pitched part of 09, part of 2011 and 12 with the big league club in Toronto with the Blue Jays. There's a strike. Then he was picked up by the Rangers, pitched at AAA Round Rock in the Pacific Coast League in 2013 and 14, and then actually didn't start pitching this year with Wichita. His first game with the Wingnuts was June the 25th. Tassone takes it down low, and it's two balls. Two balls, one strike on Tassone. Two out, nobody on, and a foul back. Tassone and Scott Richmond were teammates this summer on the Canadian national team. They both played in the Pan American Games for Team Canada. Tassone has chipped his bat. He'll have to find a new one, along with Kelgard. Kelgard, Tassone, and Richmond are all on that Canadian national team that won the Pan American Series. Two balls, two strikes on Tassone. But in 2013, 2014, Richmond was in the Rangers organization at Round Rock in the Pacific Coast League. 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss, and Tassone strikes out, and the inning is over. So Richmond gets a strikeout, and that's all for the Explorers here in the bottom of the first inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left after an inning. The Explorers nothing, and Wichita nothing. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ.
Thank you. 130 North Lewis Boulevard, Sioux City. Call 1-800-GO-HARLEY.
The 12-game winning streak, a franchise record. And the Brewers have won the 53rd game. That is a franchise record. Keep your Sioux City Explorers versus history. And you have one last chance to get this. Come here on your home time after sharing Santa's sensation news. Monday, August 24th and Sunday, August 30th.
Top of the second inning, TJ Mittelstadt, who was at the plate when the final out was recorded in the first inning. Mittelstadt leads it off here in the second. And takes Strutka's first pitch outside and high for ball one. So it's Mittelstadt, Kane, and Dean here in the second inning. There's a strike with a fastball on the outer part of the plate, and it's one ball and one strike. Outfield straight away to the left-handed hitting, TJ Mittelstadt. Lines it toward right. It's well hit down the line and out of here. A home run for Mittelstadt. His 15th home run of the year, and Wichita takes a 1-0 lead here in the second inning. That is the 10th home run given up by John Strotka this season. He has given up more home runs than any other Explorer pitcher, and Mittelstadt cranks that one out of the ballpark right down the right field line. And it's 1-0, Wichita. And now Harrison Kane coming up. So Mittelstadt with his 15th home run of the season. That's his first hit in this series. And Kane takes a breaking pitch for a strike. Kane was 0-for-6 in the doubleheader last night. 264 average, 6 home runs, 23 RBIs. Down low. So it evens it up at one ball and one strike. Harrison Kane, right-handed hitter, and hits it foul out of play down the right field line. And it's one ball and two strikes on Harrison Kane. So Wichita with a 1-0 lead here in the second inning. The 1-2 pitch to Kane. And he fouls it just past the seats off the first base side. So it's one ball and two strikes on Harrison Kane. Nobody out. And down low, Strotka misses. That evens it up at two balls and two strikes. The catcher, Brent Dean, is on deck. Top of the second inning, a 1-0 lead for Wichita. Another foul, reaching for it, fouled it back to the backstop. And it stays even at two balls and two strikes. Explorers in Wichita here tonight, and the final regular season home game for the Explorers tomorrow night here at Lewis and Clark Park. 2-2 pitch to Kane. Chops foul behind the plate, and that one jumped up and hit Kane. And it crouched over at the plate, but apparently okay. And foul ball, it stays two balls, two strikes. Tomorrow night, 7:05 game time, it will also have fireworks after the game here at Lewis and Clark Park. Explorers will be hosting the first two games of the American Association playoffs Wednesday, September the 9th, Thursday, September the 10th here at Lewis and Clark. Two balls, two strikes on Kane. Hit in the air down the right field side. Patron going over and cannot make the play. It's just out of his reach as he leaned over the fence toward the bleachers down that right field line. Couldn't quite get to it. And it stays two balls and two strikes on Harrison Kane. Wichita leading 1-0 on a leadoff home run by T.J. Mittelstadt here in the second inning. His 15th of the year, that ties him for fifth in the league in the home run department. The 2-2 pitch fouls it back again. Pitch left up a little bit in the strike zone, and Kane had a cut at it, fouled it back. Explorers in Wichita played six times last year, and Wichita won all six games. This year, the Explorers do not go to Wichita. Only the four-game series here is between the two teams this season. 2-2 pitch from Strotka. In the dirt, blocked by Matt Coach, and now it's gone full to 3-2. He had challenged him with some fastballs, and Kane had been fouling him off, so he came back with a breaking pitch but threw it in the dirt. So now it's a full count at 3-2. The 3-2 pitch. Ground ball toward third, but it'll go foul. And it stays a full count at 3-2. So Kane, being a very pesky hitter at the plate right now, fouling off. That is 10 pitches at this at bat for Harrison Kane. So as a pitcher, you start to wonder, oh, what can I throw this guy that I can get something by him or get him out? Straka looking in to get his sign from Matt Coach. Now he'll go to the short windup and the pitch. Ground ball toward third by Mendoza down the left field line. That'll be a base hit. And Kane is headed toward second base, and he'll take the turn and hold with a double. So Harrison Kane with a double after fouling off an 11-pitch at-bat. And finally doubles past Mendoza. Maybe got just the end of the glove on it at most. So that's the third hit for Wichita. Still nobody out here in the second inning for Brent Dean, the catcher. Dean caught both games of the doubleheader last night. He's in there tonight behind the plate. He was 1-for-5 in the doubleheader yesterday. 269 average with one home run, 20 RBIs. Kane at second, nobody out. Stratko's pitch almost hit him inside for ball one. One ball and no strikes on Brent Dean. He's the number 7 hitter in the batting order for Wichita. Wingnuts leading 1-0 here in the second inning. Nobody out with a runner at second, Harrison Kane. Stratka looks back at second. Now the runner going to third. No throw to third base. That'll be a stolen base for Kane. That is his 17th stolen base of the year. Stratka really didn't take a second look at the runner at second, Harrison Kane, and he just took off and sprinted to third, and Matt Coach had no chance at all and didn't make a throw to third, and so a stolen base. Explorers at first and third will play up even with a bag. Second and short, they're back at normal depth. 2-0 on Brent Dean. Stratka comes to the plate. Popped up, coming back our way, and it's going to be in the seats. And somebody got a souvenir. In the first row of the upper section, right in the lap of a young lady. And it's 2-1 on Brent Dean. Nobody out here in the second inning with Kane at third base. Stratka getting his sign from Matt Coach. 2-1 pitch. High with a fastball. And it's 2-2. Wichita with a 1-0 lead here in the second inning. TJ Mittelstadt leading off with a home run. The 51st home run as Wichita has hit this season as a team.
Yeah, because we won a game today.
3-1. This one's popped up again. That, I think, will be over the seats and out of the stadium. So now it's a full count at 3-2 on Brent Dean. Matty Johnson. Explorers center fielder shading Dean toward right center field. K Kane is at third, nobody out. And the 3-2 pitch, grounded up the middle and into center field, a base hit, and it's 2-0 Wichita. So Dean with a base hit, scoring Kane. So Wichita with a couple of runs here in the second inning and still nobody out. Dean getting his 21st RBI of the year. That is already the fourth hit for Wichita. Nobody out, and the batter will be the shortstop, Leo Vargas, who was 1-for-5 last night. Wichita making up for lost ground last night and swinging the bat here early against John Strotka. Vargas, right-handed hitter. And there goes the runner. Pitch is hit in the air. Left field coming in is Kane, and he's not going to be able to get it as the ball will fall in there for a base hit. And the reason that Rio couldn't get to it because he was overcovering the bag at second base. And at this left field wide open, it was hit high in the air. It goes a base hit. And Dean at first base had to wait till it dropped in there before he could go to second, and he got in there safely. So runners at first and second and still nobody out here in the second inning. Wichita already with 5 hits tonight. In last night's doubleheader, they had a total of 8 hits in the 2 games. And now the number 9 hitter is Taylor Smart. He was 0-for-3 last night, a 189 hitter with no home runs, 19 RBIs. Explorers will come up at the corners looking for the bunt out of the number 9 hitter in the order, Taylor Smart. Chokes up on the bat a little bit. Here is Strotka set, and he shows bunt, takes it down low, blocked out in front of the plate by Matt Coach, and it's 1-0. Wichita leading 2-0 here in the second inning, and they have runners at first and second and nobody out. Light starting to come on here at Lewis and Clark Park on this Saturday evening. Patron comes up on the grass at first base. Mendoza right at the edge of the grass at third, looking for the bunt. 1-0 pitch. It's bunted. Down toward first, up with the Patron. He'll go to first as Tassoni covering for the out. Sacrifice successful. Moves Dean over to third base. Vargas to second. So the sacrifice bunt. 3-4 on the putout for the first out of the inning. And now back to the top of the batting order in Nick Van Stratton. Flied out to left field in the first inning. To Wichita already with a 2-0 lead, threatening with runners at second and third and one out. The pitch, Van Stratton takes the breaking pitch way high for ball one. 1-0 on Nick Van Stratton. Dean at third, Vargas at second with one out. Strotka ready. 1-0 pitch. Fouled over the screen and out of the ballpark. Evens it up at 1-1 on Nick Van Stratton. Van Stratton playing in his 9th game with Wichita. Strotka looks at the runner at third. The pitch, fastball for a strike. 1-2 on Van Stratton. Hitting .421 over his last 5 games. As we said, tonight is his 9th game to play with Wichita. 1-2. Ground ball chopped toward third. Mendoza will go to first, the out there, and that's the only play they make. The runner at second base, Vargas, broke off the bag. He was about halfway to third. Mendoza threw on the first to get Van Stratten. That's the second out of the inning. So two outs, runners still at second and third for Jace Ray, who had a base hit in the first inning. Van Stratten played earlier this season with Reynosa in the Mexican League. Got about two or three players that just came to Wichita. The stretch by Stratka. Ray swings and misses, and it's strike one. No balls and one strike on Jace Ray. Two runs in here in the second inning. And Wichita leads it 2-0 over the Explorers. Two out, runners at second and third. Stratka trying to get out of this inning with minimal damage. No balls and one strike. Hit toward right field, but Lang is settling under it. Makes the catch, and the inning is over. The Ray flies to right, and it's all for Wichita here in the second inning. However, the Wingnuts get two runs in the inning. They do it with four hits. There were no errors and two left. After an inning and a half, it's Wichita 2 and the Explorers nothing. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KOCJ. Kjellgaard will lead it out for the Explorers here in the second inning. He's the designated hitter tonight. Kjellgaard, two hits, six at bats in the doubleheader last night. 294, 13 home runs, 64 RBIs on the season for Kjellgaard. Fastball in there for a strike. The last outing for Scott Richmond was on Monday. He had a no decision against St. Paul. This is inside and low, and it's one ball and one strike. He went seven in the third innings, four hits, or make that six hits, four runs, three earned. This is outside, and it's one ball and one strike. Walked one and struck out four. Kjellgaard at the plate, swing and a foul tip, and it's strike two. It is two balls and two strikes on Brock Kjellgaard. Leads it off here in the second inning for the Explorers is Richmond, the wind and the pitch. Inside, now it's going 3-2. Richmond has had wins this year over Sioux Falls, 6-4. Laredo, 2-0. Ottawa beat them 5-3. Here's a line drive into left field for a base hit. Richmond left that pitch up, and Kjellgaard greeted it with a line drive single between third and short. So the Explorers have their first base runner and their first hit of the game. For Noah Perillo, left-handed hitter. Perillo 1-for-7 in the doubleheader last night. Richmond also beat Grand Prairie 2-0. His only loss this year was his first start with Wichita, and that was back on June the 25th. He lost to Joplin 4-2. He's gone at least five innings in all of his starts, and this is his ninth start of the year. Rio looks at a strike. 322 average, six home runs, 63 RBIs. Kelgard at first base with a leadoff single. Explores trail. 2-0 here in the bottom of the second inning. No balls, one strike on Perillo. Richmond, the pause and the pitch, and it's line foul. That one against the screen and bounces up into the seats on the concourse on the third base side. So it's now no balls and two strikes on Noah Perillo. Kelgard leading it off here in the second inning with a base hit. Manager Steve Montgomery coaching at third. Pitching coach Bobby Post at first. 0-2 pitch. Here's a ball hit up the middle. Shortstop getting to it and throws to first, and they get the double play. Nice play by Vargas at shortstop. Kind of stumbled a little bit after he caught the ball, reached back, tagged the bag, and gets the double play. It goes 6-3 on the Twin Killer. And so now there is two out and nobody on base. That's the first double play that Wichita has turned in this series. For the year, it's their 90th they have turned. Now with two out and nobody on, Tommy Mendoza coming up. Richmond's pitch, fouled it back, and it's strike one. Mendoza on a four-game hitting streak. 2-for-7 last night. Average at 321 for the year. In tight with a fastball, and evens it up at one ball and one strike on Mendoza. So Wichita turning the double play after the leadoff single by Kelgard here in the second. Fouled off to the left, and that will be out of the ballpark on the third base side. So Richmond ahead of the count at one ball and two strikes. On Tommy Mendoza, the 1-2 pitch, in tight again, and it evens it up at two balls and two strikes. Scott Richmond, right-hander, on the hill tonight for Wichita with the pitch. Strike three call on the outside corner. Mendoza caught looking. Richmond gets his second strikeout, and that's all for the Explorers here in the second inning. No runs on one hit, no errors, and nobody left. After two, it's Wichita 2 and the Explorers nothing. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ.
Thank you.
Top of the third inning here at Lewis and Clark Park as Wichita leading 2-0 over the Explorers. Brent Cleveland will lead it out for the Wingnuts. Wingnuts right now in first place in the South Division. They have a four-game lead over second place Laredo in the South. So they're getting close to wrapping up the South Division. Explorers and St. Paul have already won their way into the playoffs. Here's Cleveland taking a strike. Cleveland walked in the first inning. So Wichita with a 2-0 lead as we're in the top of the third inning. John Strotka to the plate. Fouled over the screen and out of the park off the first base side. Strotka getting ahead of Cleveland at no balls and two strikes. Tomorrow night's game will start at 7:05. Hours later start than normal on a Sunday. Breaking pitch, strike three call. Good breaking pitch there. Came right over the top. Strotka gets his first strikeout. That's the first out here in the third inning. Cleveland caught looking. One out for Andy LaRoche. Called out a ball that was hit in front of the plate and hit him, so it goes as a catcher unassisted put out. Bounces one foul past manager Kevin Hooper at third, and it's strike one. Fireworks tomorrow night, though, after the game. And that's why we start an hour later on a Sunday, normally 6:05, but tomorrow night, 7:05 game time. And again, fireworks after the game tomorrow. 0-1 pitch. Strike two on the inside corner. So Strotka gets ahead of LaRoche. Had no balls and two strikes, and the pitch just off the plate outside, and it's 1-2. Once again, Strotka is always a quick worker when no one's on base. And the 1-2 pitch, chopped foul. That one will make its way into the Explorers third base dugout. So it stays one ball, two strikes on LaRoche. 2-0, Wichita leading. We're in the top of the third inning. Strotka with a 1-2 delivery. Down low and outside. Came over the top with a breaking pitch, and it's even at 2-2. Strotka's 19th start of the year. Another foul that will be out of the ballpark off the first base side. So it stays two balls and two strikes. Wichita scored their two runs in the second inning. TJ Middlestadt led off the second with a home run, and then after a double by Kane, a base hit by Dean. And Wichita a 2-0 lead. Swing and a miss. Good pitch down around the knees. So LaRoche strikes out. Back-to-back strikeouts for Strotka to start the third inning. So two out. TJ Middlestadt, who had the home run to lead off the second inning for bat. He is now tied for fifth in the league in the home run department with 15. Also leads Wichita with 62 RBI. Swing and a miss, and it's strike one. No balls and a strike on TJ Middlestadt. Play the left-handed hitter straight away in the outfield. Low it inside. Hit the dirt. And it's a ball and a strike on Middlestadt. Strotka with a 1-1 pitch. This one's hit high and deep to right center field. Matty Johnson on the run, looking up, and it's off the fence. Middlestadt headed toward second, and he'll stop there with a double. He didn't miss his second home run by more than 3 or 4 feet. Just to the right of the flagpoles in center field, just to the right of that. So Middlestadt has a home run on a double tonight in his first two at-bats. That is the sixth hit for Wichita. So Middlestadt That was his 19th double of the year. He's had 15 home runs, 62 RBIs. So he's having himself a pretty good year. Average-wise, only 257. Now with two outs and Mittelstadt at second, Harrison Kane. Hits one toward center field. Matty Johnson coming in and makes the catch on the run for the final out here in the third inning. No runs, a hit, no errors, and one left after two and a half. It's Wichita 2 and the Explorers nothing. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. It'll be the bottom third of the batting order for the Explorers here in the third inning. Matt Coach, Eno Patron, and Brent Keyes. Checking our out-of-town American Association scoreboard. Fargo Moorhead pouring it on Winnipeg tonight. 9-0 over the Goldeyes at Winnipeg in the seventh inning. Matt Coach, 0-4 in the doubleheader last night. 284 on the season for the right-handed hitter. Takes it down low for ball one. Sioux Falls is shutting out Lincoln 3-0 there in the top of the seventh inning at Lincoln. One ball and no strikes on Matt Coach. It's outside. Now it's 2-0. Two balls and no strikes. Laredo leading Amarillo 4-2 in the sixth inning. New Jersey 4-0 over Gary South Shore in the third. 2-0 pitch is taken for a strike, and it's 2-1. Joplin shutting out Grand Prairie, 2-0 in the third inning at Joplin. And St. Paul and Kansas City are 1-1 in the third at Kansas City. 2-1 pitch, it's bounced foul toward the on-deck circle on the third base side. That evens it up at two balls and two strikes on Matt Coach. 2-0 lead for Wichita here in the third. Scott Richmond, right-hander to the plate. Line drive, and it will be in right center field for a base hit. So Matt Coach gets his first base hit in this series, a leadoff single here in the third, second hit for the Explorers. This will bring Eno Patron to the plate. Patron hasn't played for a while. His average with the Explorers this season is .275 with no home runs, three RBIs, left-handed hitter. So Eno Patron, he's been working out with the ball club and taking batting practice every day and just activated today as the Explorers could expand their roster as all the other teams in the league to 23 instead of 22. Pitch to Patron, fouls it off to the left side, that'll be out of play. And it's strike one. No balls and one strike Although Patron has not played in a game for a while, he has been able to take BP and infield and all of that. Coach is at first base with the leadoff single here in the third inning. Patron hits it in the air, left center field. Van Stratton moving that way and will make the catch for the first out, and Coach back to first base. So one out here in the third for Brent Keyes. Keyes 1-for-2 last night. 3.36 average, no home runs, 11 RBIs for the left-handed hitting left fielder Brent Keyes, batting in the number 9 spot in the batting order. So Matt Coach is still at first base with one out. Swimmers have had two hits tonight off the Wichita right-hander Scott Richmond. Double play depth in the infield, and the pitch to Keyes. Takes it off the plate outside, and it's ball one. The Roach at first, Smart at second, Vargas at short, Mittelstadt at third base for Wichita in the infield. One ball, no strikes on Keyes. Long pause by Richmond, and he lines it fair down the right field line. This is headed toward the corner. Here comes Coach around third, and he's going to be held right there as the ball quickly comes in from the right fielder, Kane, to the cutoff man, and they held Coach at third base. Keyes will get a double. So the Explorers have the runners at second and third with one out. So Brent Keyes gets his fifth double of the season and out to the top of the batting order in Matty Johnson. Flied out to left field in the first inning. So Johnson will bat. One out, runners second and third. Explorers trail 2-0 here in the third inning. So Richmond from the stretch. And Johnson takes the breaking pitch inside for ball one. What was really funny about the at-bat by Keyes, he was actually trying to call timeout before the pitch came, and the umpire disregarded it. Keyes gets the double. Johnson, change up, taken for strike one, and it's one ball and one strike. Ball and a strike on Matty Johnson. We have one out here in the third inning. Explorers trailing 2-0, have runners at second and third. Richmond set with the 1-1 pitch to Johnson. Hits it in the air towards center field. Van Stratton will make the catch, tagging but holding at third as the strong throw comes in from Van Stratton, not deep enough to get Coach in, and now there's two out. So two out, runners still at second and third for Michael Lang. They're lined out to center field in the first inning. So Lang will bat with two out. Ball wasn't hit deep enough. Coach is not the fastest of a foot anyway, and so they held him at third. And now Lang will bat with two out. And he fouls it out of play to the right side, and that one may make the seats, and it does, off the first base side, and it's strike one. No balls and one strike on Michael Lang. Lang is currently tied for first in the league in hitting with Benny DeFazio of St. Paul, both with a 3.55 average. Breaking pitch down and away. Nice save by Dean as he scrambled to his right to block that pitch. And it's one ball and one strike on Michael Lang. Coach at third. At second base is Keyes. Two out in the inning. As Richmond, the wind and the pitch. Here's a ball hit toward shortstop. Up with it, Vargas on the first. Digging it out is LaRoche, and the Explorers are turned away here in the third inning. Had runners at second and third and one out, but failed to score. No runs in the inning. There were two hits, no errors, and two left. After three innings, it's Wichita 2 and the Explorers nothing. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. Totals through three innings. It's Wichita with two runs. They have six hits, no errors, and the Explorers, no runs on three hits and no errors. We go to the top of the fourth inning. It'll be the bottom third of the batting order for the Wingnuts. It'll be Brent Dean, Leo Vargas, and Taylor Smart against the Explorers right-hander John Strotka. Dean had an RBI single in the second inning, drove in one of the two runs that Wichita scored in that second, and lines this one to left field. This one's going to be extra bases down into the corner, and Dean is headed towards second base. The throw will not be in time, and Dean has two for two tonight. That is his double tonight for Dean. Is his eighth of the year. So that's the third double by Wichita tonight. So that is seven hits tonight for Wichita as we're in the fourth inning. Nobody out with Dean at second base and Leo Vargas coming up. Dean is really their backup catcher. Number one catcher, John Nestor, is out of town attending a wedding this weekend. He will probably be back Sunday, tomorrow, we were told. So Dean, two hits tonight. He's making the best of his limited playing time. Here's Leo Vargas, who had a base hit in the second inning. Nobody out. Dean at second. And Strotka's pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. No balls and a strike on Leo Vargas. Kind of a hazy cloud above us tonight here in Sioux City. Lights have been turned on. We're in the fourth inning with a 2-0 lead for Wichita. No balls, one strike on Vargas. In the dirt, blocked by Matt Coach, and it's a ball and a strike. Wichita getting close to clinching the South Division of the American Association. They have a four-game lead over Laredo. Dean down at second. Nobody out. Strotka looks back at second. Again and again. And now to the plate. Here's a ball hit right up the middle into center field, a base hit. Here comes Dean around third. Here comes the throw. It'll be cut off. And Dean will stop at third base. And Vargas has two hits. He is two for two tonight. That is the eighth hit off Skrotka. So Wichita with eight hits tonight, they have already matched their output last night in the doubleheader. They had eight hits in the two games. And nobody out here in the fourth. And Taylor Smart will come up. He had a sacrifice bunt in the second inning. Taking a long look at manager Kevin Upper at third base, going through some signs. Now talking with Dean, who is at third base. So Stratka set and the pitch. It's in there for a strike to Taylor Smart. Stratka is yet to retire Wichita in order tonight. They have had base runners in every inning. They lead it 2-0 and have runners at first and third and nobody out here in the fourth. Double play depth in the infield with nobody out. The pitch taken off the plate outside, a breaking pitch missing. And it's one ball and one strike on Taylor Smart. 1 ball and one strike on Smart. Vargas at first, Dean at third with nobody out. Stratka pauses right at the letters on the stretch. 1-1 pitch, down and away. And it's 2 balls and one strike. Wichita with a 2-0 lead, threatening here in the fourth with runners at first and third and nobody out. Two balls and a strike on Smart. Batting in the number 9 spot in the order. Swing and a miss. Came back with a fastball and Smart swung right through it. Now it evens it up at 2 balls and 2 strikes on Taylor Smart. Dean led off the inning with a double. Vargas with a line drive single to center. Dean stopped at third. Nobody out. And Stratka, 2-2 pitch. Foul tipped it right off the mitt of the catcher, Matt Coach. So it stays 2 balls and 2 strikes. Ryan Struffing will get the start tomorrow night for the Explorers. Right-hander Tim Brown will get the start for Wichita in the final game of this series tomorrow. 2 balls, 2 strikes on Smart. Runners first and third. Line drive, base hit, left field. And now it's a 3-0 game. As Smart singles sharply to left field, scoring Dean to make it a 3-0 lead. Stopping at second base is Vargas. And still nobody out in the inning. That's the 9th hit for Wichita. And now we go back to the top of the batting order. In Nick Van Stratten. Smart getting his 20th RBI of the year with that line drive single to right field. Nobody out, and Van Stratten has flied to left and grounded to third. Van Stratten, right-handed hitter, takes it a strike. Not real happy with that call by home plate umpire Scott Shores. No balls and one strike. Nobody warming right now in the Explorers bullpen, but a couple of pitchers are up kind of stretching, so they may be up throwing here pretty quickly. 3-0 lead for Wichita in the fourth. Stratka, there goes the runners. The pitch is fouled out of play. A little hit and run by Wichita. Vargas at second was headed to third, and Smart at first base was headed to second on a hit and run, but Van Stratten fouled it out of play, and it's no balls, two strikes on the right-handed hitter. Van Stratten was at Reynosa in the Mexican League this year. Just joined the Wichita Ball Club, and playing in his ninth game with the Wingnuts. No balls, two strikes on Van Stratton. Fouls it again. That one out of play off the first base side, and it stays. No balls and two strikes. Wichita with three runs, nine hits, and we're in the fourth inning with runners at first and second and nobody out. Strike ahead of the count at 0-2. Checks the runner at second, looks back there again, and now to the plate. And a curveball hit him on the left shoulder. Nope. Oh, they're going to say that he didn't try to get out of the way of it. That's an interesting call. I see this, you know, a lot of times in college baseball. I think that's one of the first times I've ever seen it in professional baseball. And Kevin Hooper is arguing his point with the home plate umpire, Scott Shores. Boy, you don't see that often at all. Very seldom. I can't remember the last time I saw that call or not call. It hit him on the left shoulder, a breaking pitch. But they say it's a ball, and so it'll be one ball and two strikes on Nick Van Stratton. Very unusual there. The Explorers may have gotten a break there. As Stratka comes to the plate, and a line drive, right field, base hit. Around third is Vargas. He's headed to the plate. The throw will not be in time. Took a bad bounce, and coach is able to knock it down as Vargas scores from second base on the single by Van Stratton. That's his ninth RBI since joining Wichita, and still nobody out in the inning. And now it's a 4-0 lead for Wichita. Over to third base goes Taylor Smart on the base hit to right field. So it's a 4-0 lead for Wichita. And they have runners at first and third. Still nobody out here in the fourth inning for Jace Ray. Ray has singled and fly to right. Stratka, check to the runner. Here's the pitch. It's high for a ball. One ball to no strikes. It has been a struggle for John Stratka here tonight. One ball, no strikes on Ray. Here's a ground ball into right field, a base hit. Van Stratton around second. He is headed toward third. The throw will get away, and now another run will score. Two runs will score. It'll be a base hit, an RBI. The second run will score on the throwing error by Lang. So Smart has scored. Also scoring is Van Stratton. On the base hit, Ray goes to second base with the RBI and the error on Lang. So now it is a 6-0 lead for Wichita, and still nobody out here in the fourth inning. And the Explorers still have no one throwing in the bullpen as of yet. Ray will get one RBI. The second one will score on the throwing error by Lang. It's now a 6-0 lead for Wichita. And the batter, Brent Cleveland, who has walked and struck out tonight. So Wichita doing a little payback to the Explorers for what they did to them last night. Here's the ball hit toward right center field. Matty Johnson on the run. Matty will not be able to catch up with this one. It's headed to the fence, and another run will score at second base with a double is Cleveland. And it's now a 7-0 lead for Wichita. And still nobody out here in the fourth inning.
Come on.
Bobby Post making his way out of the dugout, out to the mound. But they have hit John Straka hard tonight. A double by Cleveland and an RBI. So all the runs will be earned now. And it's a 7-0 lead for Wichita. Last night, the Explorers won 12-1 and 9-0. And Wichita, with a payback here this evening, early in this one, they lead it 7-0. And Andy LaRoche, who struck out swinging his last time up, he's 0-2. Batting with nobody out here in the fourth inning. Straka to the plate. This one's hit in the air to center field. It's playable for Matty Johnson. And he'll make the catch, and that's the first out of the inning. So one out here in the fourth. Cleveland stayed at second base. And T.J. Mittelstadt got the scoring started for Wichita in the second inning with a leadoff second inning home run. It was his 15th of the year. He will bat. He has also had a double tonight along with the home run. So Wichita leading 7-0 here in the fourth inning. With a runner at second base, Cleveland. Explorers are starting to get some activity in the bullpen. And it will be Billy Bullock, who is beginning to loosen down in that left field corner. Mittelstadt at the plate. In the dirt, blocked by Coach. And it's one ball to no strikes on T.J. Mittelstadt. Wichita has scored 5 runs here in the fourth inning. They now lead it 7-0. One ball, no strikes on Mittelstadt. High and outside, and it's 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. No, one out here in the fourth inning with a runner at second. Fouled out of play to the left side, and it's a ball and a strike. Should be 2 balls, 1 strike. Now we got it. 2 balls, 1 strike on T.J. Mittelstadt. So Straka has given up 11 hits here, and we're in the fourth inning. Right-hander ready. 2-1 pitch. Down low, and now it's going to 3-1. 3 balls and 1 strike. The 11 hits that Straka has given up tonight, that matches the most he has given up in a game when he went 3 2/3 innings and gave up 11 hits to Laredo. 3-1 is the count on Mittelstadt. Takes it high, and he walks. Second walk given up by Straka. And now Harrison Kane becomes the ninth batter to come to the plate in this inning. Kane has doubled, scored a run, and flied to center. It's a 7-0 lead for Wichita in the fourth. They have runners at first and second, one out. Line foul out of play down the right field line. And it's 2 balls and 1 strike on Harrison Kane. Cleveland at second. Mittelstadt is at first. He's been on base all 3 times tonight. Mittelstadt has. Home run, a double, and a walk. No balls and 1 strike on Kane. He hits one toward right field, coming hard and making a diving catch. Is holding on to it, rolling on the ground was Michael Lang. Lang made a diving catch and held on to it as he rolled head over foot. And that's the second out of the inning.
What a play.
So two out here in the fourth inning. And now Brent Dean, who led off this inning with a double and later scored, becomes the 10th batter in the inning. For Wichita, with runners at first and second, and now two out. As Stratka to the plate, popped him up, shallow center field. Tassoni going back and making the catch from his second base position for the final out here in the fourth inning. But a big fourth inning for Wichita. Wichita scoring 5 runs in the inning. They do it with 6 hits. There was 1 Sioux City error and 2 left. After 3.5 innings, it's Wichita 7 and the Explorers nothing. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. Renee Tassoni to lead it off here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Takes it down low for ball one. Tassoni, Kelgard, and Perillo to bat here in the fourth against the right-hander Scott Richmond, who has a 7-0 lead for his ball club. Pitches outside, and it's 2-0. Tassoni struck out swinging in the first inning. Leads it off here in the bottom of the fourth. 2 balls, no strikes on Tassoni. And it's high, and now it's 3-0. 3 balls and no strikes. These two guys were teammates this summer in the Pan American game, playing for the Canadian national team. There's a strike, and it's 3-1. 3 balls and 1 strike. The 3-1 delivery. Popped him high in the air, shallow center. Who's going to call for it? And Van Stratten, the center fielder, coming in and calls and makes the catch for the first out. One out here in the fourth inning for Brock Kelgard, who had a base hit in the second, but then was erased in part of a double play in which Perillo hit into. Explorers have had 3 hits tonight, one by Kelgard, one by Coach, and Keys. Kelgard takes a strike. No balls, 1 strike on Kelgard. 1 out, nobody on. Down low and inside, and it's 1-1. Scott Richmond making his 9th start with Wichita. The 1-1 pitch. Hit to left field. It's well hit. It's up, and it is gone. Kelgard drives that one out of here in left field. His 14th home run of the year. field fence by Kelgard. That's the fifth home run that Richmond has given up this season. Kelgard left no doubt in that one when it left the bat. So it's now a 7-1 lead as the Explorers get on the board here in the fourth inning on Kelgard's solo home run. And now Noah Perillo hit into a double play in the second inning at the plate. High and outside for ball one. Perillo grounded into that double play back in the second inning. Bats with one out here in the fourth. Punches one in the air. Third baseman Mittelstadt chasing it and cannot make the play. Just past the Explorers dugout. Leaning toward that fence, couldn't quite hang on to it, so no play. And one ball and one strike on Perillo. So it's 7-1 Wichita as the Explorers get on the scoreboard here in the fourth inning on the home run by Kelgard. Right-hander Scott Richmond. And now time is called as Perillo asks and got time and steps out of the batter's box, reworks the batting gloves. We have one out here in the fourth. And a breaking pitch a little high for ball two. Two balls and one strike. Two balls, one strike on Perillo. Outside, and now it's going to 3-1. Tommy Mendoza is on deck. We have one out here in the fourth inning. Three balls, one strike on Noah Perillo. Richmond a long look in, and now Perillo figured he had taken too much time, and he stepped out of the batter's box again. The pitch from Richmond. Swing and a miss. So now it's a full count at 3-2. Perillo with a big cut at that pitch. A full count on the Explorer shortstop. Richmond with a 3-2 pitch. Here's a ball hit toward shortstop. Try to backhand it. Vargas, it skips on into left field. And Perillo will be at first base. Vargas went about one step to his right. He tried to backhand it. It skipped off his glove and scooted on into left field. And Tommy Mendoza will come up. It'll be a base hit for Perillo. Explorers get their fifth hit of the game. Mendoza was called out on strikes in the second inning. Perillo at first with one out and a strike taken by Tommy Mendoza on the outer part of the plate from the right-hander Scott Richmond. He'll be 36 years old tomorrow. No balls and a strike on Tommy Mendoza. Down low with a breaking pitch that evens it up at a ball and a strike. Off-speed breaking pitch there by Richmond, but he missed low on it. And it's 1-1. Mendoza on a four-game hitting streak coming into tonight's contest. Perillo short lead at first. Richmond the stretch and the pitch. In there for a strike, another backdoor breaking pitch. On the outer part of the plate to the left-handed hitting Mendoza. And Richmond ahead of him at one ball, two strikes. 7-1, Wichita leading. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning. Play Mendoza straight away in the outfield. Now time has been called. Mendoza stepped out, now back in. Infield for Wichita at double play depth. The 1-2 pitch missed outside with a fastball. And it's two balls and two strikes. Two balls, two strikes on Tommy Mendoza. Three at first. Swing and a miss. And Mendoza strikes out for the second time. That's the third strikeout for Scott Richmond. So now there's two out with a runner at first. For Matt Coach, who had a base hit in the third inning but was left stranded. The Explorers stranded a couple of base runners, actually had runners at second and third and one out but failed to score. So Matt Coach will bat with two out and Perillo at first. Coach takes strike one. With a 7-1 lead by Wichita, it kind of takes the Explorers out of their, basically out of their game plan, because they like to run, they like to hit and run, like to steal, and when you're down by six, can't afford to do much of that. Fouled out of play to the right, and it's strike two, no balls, two strikes on Matt Coach. That's the way the Explorers have played this game all season long. They've been very successful at it, winning 69 games. 17 more games they have won this year than any other Sioux City club in Explorers history since the Explorers became a ball club in 1993. No balls, two strikes. Tap foul off to the right side. Just got a piece of it. Rolled it toward the first base Wichita dugout. And it stays. No balls and two strikes. Wichita set the American Association record last year for the most wins. When they won the title, they ended up with 73 wins a year ago. And the Explorers are four shy of that, tying that record with 69 already this season. No balls, two strikes on Matt Coach. Three at first, two out. And a line drive down the right field line, a fair ball over to cut it off. And here comes to the plate, Perillo. He will score standing on a double. Coach went right down the right field line. It probably wasn't fair by over a foot or so. Now, did they call it a ground rule double or not? Now, that's, here comes Steve Linton out the check, and it is going to be a ground rule double, so the run will not count. It got in that between the fence and the opening of that fence down beyond the visitor's bullpen. So Perillo will be stopped at third base on the ground rule double by Matt Coach, his second hit of the game. Sixth hit for the Explorers. Runners are at second and third with two out. So instead of Perillo being able to score from first base, the ground rule double will push him back to third. With two outs, Eno Patron. Right out to center field in the third inning. So Patron will bat with two outs. For the second consecutive inning, the Explorers have had runners at second and third, and Patron takes a strike. It's a 7-1 lead for Wichita. Explorers trying to peck and try to get back into this game. Almost hitting. As Patron bails out of the way of a pitch in tight. And it's one ball and one strike on Eno Patron. Richmond, the wind and the pitch. Down low. And it's 2-1. Back in the third inning, the last inning, the Explorers had actually had runners at second and third, and one out was failed to score. Second and third with two out here in the fourth inning. And Richmond started to go to the windup and then backed off the rubber. Looks back in to get his sign from Brent Dean, his catcher. Now he's ready. with the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. And Patron, bat has caught the catcher, Dean, on his backswing. Dean getting up slowly behind home plate. Kevin Hooper out to take a look at him, along with the Wichita trainer, but Dean says he's all right. And it was the backswing by Patron that got him. Hit him right in the helmet. He went down and popped back up and out to talk with his pitcher, Scott Richmond. And again, Dean is basically their backup catcher. Their number one catcher is out of town for the weekend. Should be back tomorrow, we understand. Two balls, two strikes. Ground ball, second base. Up with it, Smart. On to first for the out, and that's all for the Explorers. Turned away again, leaving a couple of runners on base here in the fourth inning. No runs in the inning. The Explorers will make that one run in the inning. One run, three hits in the inning. There were no errors and two left. After four, it's Wichita 7, the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ.
If any trash you like our game day staff members to dispose of for you, please provide it to the New York game day staff members that are currently making their way through the crowd. For all your cleaning needs, please contact Fresh Start Janitorial and Property Services at 402-494-9980.
Hey, Jamie, new pitcher. We'll get a new pitcher for the Explorers here in the fifth inning. It's going to be right-hander Billy Bullock. So Stronka has his second shortest outing of the season as he goes four innings tonight. Gave up 12 hits, 7 runs with 2 walks, 2 strikeouts. So the new pitcher, Billy Bullock, here in the fifth inning. Appearing in his 32nd game of the year, 2 wins, 1 loss. 40 and a third innings, 44 strikeouts, 27 walks. His last outing was against Gary. And that came on Tuesday night, went 2/3 of an inning and took the loss, 4-0. In relief, went 2/3 of an inning, gave up 2 hits, 3 runs all earned, walked 3 and didn't strike out anybody. So the Explorers have had to go to the bullpen early tonight here in the fifth inning as Bullock in relief and Leo Vargas will lead it off for Wichita. And he takes a strike. Vargas is 2-for-2, a couple of singles, and he has scored a run. Wichita with a 7-1 lead over the Explorers. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Down and away with a breaking pitch, and it's a ball and a strike. Vargas, Smart, and then the top of the order, Van Stratton. Here in the top of the fifth inning for Wichita. Explorers won last night in a doubleheader. Wichita with the lead tonight. Down low, and it's 2 balls and 1 strike on Vargas. Vargas, who played at Lincoln last year, some of the season with the Salt Dogs. Bullock with a 2-1 pitch. In there for a strike. So it evens up at 2 balls and 2 strikes on Leo Vargas. Had a single in the second, a single in the fourth. Scored in the fourth inning. Right-handed hitter. 2-2 pitch. Did he go or not? Let's see. He did not on the appeal. Steve Linton, the first base umpire, palms down, said he didn't go. He checked it in time. So now it's a full count at 3 balls and 2 strikes. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Wichita with a 7-1 lead. There's a ground ball toward shortstop. Prio bobbles it, comes up, throws to first, and got him at first base. Nice play by Patron. Nice long stretch, and he was able to backhand it, digging it out of the dirt. Nice play by Eno Patron for the first out here in the fifth inning. So one out here in the fifth for Taylor Smart. Had an RBI single his last time up in the fourth inning and then later scored. Wichita scored 5 runs in the fourth inning after 2 runs they had scored in the second. Smart had a sacrifice bunt in the second inning. Right-handed hitter with batting with 1 out here in the top of the fifth. Bullock's first pitch is in there for strike 1. No balls and 1 strike on Smart. Inside, almost hitting, and it's a ball and a strike. Taylor Smart getting the job at second base now. Wichita traded David Espinosa to St. Paul just before the trading deadline last night. 1-1 pitch. It's low. And it's 2 balls and 1 strike. Wichita will get a player from St. Paul. 2 balls, 1 strike. So David Espinosa left after the game last night. Here's a ground ball. Shortstop again. Prio bobbles it, and he will have a play, and that'll be an error. Right at Perillo at shortstop, the Explorers have committed their second error tonight. That puts Smart at first base, and now to the top of the batting order, Nick Van Stratton. Van Stratton has had an RBI single in 3 at-bats. He's also rounded out the third and flied to left. Updating some scores around the league tonight. St. Paul leading Kansas City 2-1 there in the seventh inning at Kansas City. Bullock's pitch in tight for ball 1. Grand Prairie and Joplin are now tied at 2-2. They're playing in Joplin tonight. Joplin still in the running for a wild card spot. That game in the fifth inning. 1 ball, no strikes on Van Stratton. Breaking pitch down low. So now it's 2 balls and no strikes. Our first final score already in tonight. Sioux Falls has shut out Lincoln 5-0 at Lincoln. 2-0 pitch. High again, and now it's 3-0. Three balls, no strikes on Nick Van Stratton. Smart at first base, 1 out. Fastball poured in there for a strike. New Jersey shutting out Gary Southshore, 4-0, that game in the fourth. Three-one pitch, swing and a miss. And it's strike 2. Fargo pounding Winnipeg tonight. They're in the ninth inning at Winnipeg. Fargo Moorhead 11 and Winnipeg nothing. Laredo leading Amarillo 8-3 in the eighth. Full count 3-2. Smart going. Pitches outside. Ball 4. So So Smart was off and running with the pitch. He'll take second base on the walk to Van Stratton. The Trenters at first and second with one out. First walk given up by Bullock, third of the night by the Explorers pitchers. And Jace Ray, who's had an RBI single, he is 2-for-3 tonight with that RBI in the fourth inning, and he's also scored a run. Left-handed hitter. Runners first and second, and Bullock misses high for ball one. One ball to no strikes on Jace Ray. Smart at second. Van Stratton is at first with one out. Low and inside, and now it's 2-0. Two balls, no strikes on Ray. Flores infield, a double play depth. One out here in the fifth inning. Bullock has fallen behind, 2-0 on Jace Ray. 2-0 pitch. Inside, now it's ball three. So three balls and no strikes on the left-handed hitting left fielder, Jace Ray. Bullock's 3-0 pitch. Strike one call. Ray taking all the way, and it's 3-1 on the left-handed hitter. John Strzok has started. Only went four innings tonight, though. Bullock comes on here in the fifth inning in relief. 3-1 pitch. Ground ball off the right side. Fielding at Patrone. He'll go to second out there. No return throw to first. Patrone fielding it. Turning and throwing to Pereira at shortstop. They get the force on Van Stratton for the second out of the inning. On the play, Smart moves on over to third. And Ray is at first on the fielder's choice. So now there's two out with runners at first and third for Brent Cleland, who's walked, he has doubled, driven in a run. He's also struck out. 1-for-2 tonight, right-handed hitter. He bats with two out and runners at the corners. As Bullock is set, in the dirt, bounces away, and coach will find it. No advancement or an attempt by either of the runners. Smart at third, Ray at first, held their ground. And it's one ball and no strikes on Cleveland. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Wichita with a 7-1 lead over the Explorers. Billy Bullock in relief here in the fifth inning. The pitch, high and inside, and it's 2-0. So he continues to work behind the hitters on the count. That's always very dangerous because you get to 2-0 or even 3-1. That's kind of a hitter's count. Two balls, no strikes. Broken bat, little blooper. First baseman Patrone will make the catch, and the inning is over. Cleveland popped it up to first, broke his bat, and that's all for Wichita in the fifth. No runs in the inning. There were no hits, one Explorer error, and two left. We're halfway home on a Saturday night through 4.5 innings. It's Wichita 7, the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. These contestants are going to...
live life differently. And at Sportsgrid, you'll find sports on TV, a relaxing neck and shoulder massage, our legendary hot steam towel, and a great haircut. Sportsgrid, good to be a guy.
This is Sportsgrid at Lakeport Commons in Sioux City. Open every day and no appointment needed.
The 12-game winning streak, a franchise record. As the Explorers have won their 53rd game, that is a franchise record.
Each year, Sioux City Explorers versus history. And you have one last chance to get this one. Come here on your hometown extra during Fan Appreciation Week. Monday, August 24th through Sunday, August 30th at 7:05. We're going to be every night of the week. Enjoy 25-cent hot dogs, dollar sodas, and dollar draft beers. It's the final push for the playoffs.
Bottom of the fifth inning, Brent Keyes will lead it off for the Explorers. Had a double in the third inning. This is his second at bat tonight. Left-handed hitter. Fouls it back to the backstop, and it's strike one. Keyes, Matty Johnson, Michael Lang. Here in the bottom of the fifth inning with Wichita leading 7-1. Right-hander Scott Britzman on the hill tonight. Here's a ground ball, first base. Keyes rounds it right at LaRoche. He'll take it himself, and Keyes is the first out here in the fifth inning. One out, back to the top of the order. Matty Johnson has flied to left and flied to center. 0 for 2. Looking at some of the major league scores tonight, Phillies are leading the Padres 4-3. That game in the top of the ninth inning at Philadelphia. Johnson batting from the left side against the right-hander Richmond. Change up outside and high for ball one. Pirates 4-1 over the Rockies. They're in the eighth inning at Pittsburgh. Mariners 5-2 over the White Sox in the seventh inning at Chicago. There's a strike. And it's one ball and one strike on Matty Johnson. The Angels and the Indians are 3-3 in the seventh inning at Cleveland. One ball, one strike on Matty Johnson. Strike two on another changeup on the outside corner. And it's one ball, two strikes. Brewers and the Reds in a slugfest tonight at Milwaukee. It's 9-8 Brewers in the sixth. Outside. Missed with a fastball, and it's 2-2. In that Milwaukee-Cincinnati game, there have been a total of 24 hits in the first six innings of that game. Two balls, two strikes. Richmond's pitch. Swing and a miss as Matty Johnson strikes out. Fourth strikeout for Scott Richmond. And there's two out here in the fifth inning. Two out for Michael Lang. Lang is 0 for 2. He is lined to center and grounded to short. Astros have a 4-1 lead over the Twins. They play at Target Field in Minneapolis in the eighth inning. Lang grounds it, third base. Mittelstadt on to first, and the Explorers go quickly up and down in order here in the fifth inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left. Our score after five, it's Wichita 7, and the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ.
Hey fans, it's now time.
Record. And the Explorers have won their 53rd game. That is a franchise record. Each year, Sioux City Explorers versus
history, and you have one last chance to get this thing. Come here on your hometown after during Fan Appreciation Week, Monday, August 24th through Sunday, August 30th at 7:05. We'll be getting every night of the week. Enjoy 25-cent hot dogs, dollar sodas, and dollar draft beer. It's the final sweep of the playoffs. Don't miss it.
Now batting with number 32, Andy LaRoche.
Top of the sixth inning, Andy LaRoche will lead it off for Wichita. It'll be the middle third of the batting order, LaRoche, Mittelstadt, and Kane. Billy Bullock starts his second inning of relief work for the Explorers. Misses high for ball one. Finishing up at Major League scoreboard. Yankees are leading the Braves 3-1 in Atlanta. They're in the top of the ninth inning. Bullock's 1-0 pitch. Taken for a strike. Orioles and the Rangers. Rangers have a 4-3 lead over the Orioles. They're in the bottom of the seventh inning at Arlington, Texas. Diamondbacks and the A's. 2-2 in Phoenix in the seventh inning. 1-1 pitch. Low for a ball, and it's 2-1. Cubs have a 1-0 lead over the Dodgers. They're in the bottom of the third inning in Los Angeles. Blue Jays had 18 hits today. They beat the Detroit Tigers 15-1 in Toronto. Two balls and one strike on LaRoche. Bounces a foul back to the backstop, and it's 2-2. Red Sox beat the Mets in New York 3-1. Cardinals shut out the Giants 6-0 at San Francisco. Royals win at Tampa Bay 6-3 over the Rays. Nationals 5, Marlins 1, a final. Two balls, two strikes. Down and away with a breaking pitch, and it's going full at 3-2. So that's a recap of what's happened in baseball around the big leagues on this Saturday. We'll check all the scores on our postgame show tonight. LaRoche leading it off here in the top of the sixth. Full count, 3-2. Outside, ball four. And LaRoche has walked the leadoff here in the sixth. Second walk given up by Bullock. That's the fourth walk given up by the Explorers pitchers. Leadoff walk will bring T.J. Mittelstadt to the plate, and he has been on base all three times. Had the solo home run in the second inning that started the second. He had a double in the third, walked in the fourth. Left-handed hitter batting with LaRoche at first. Nobody out. The stretch by Bullock, and the pitch. It's taken for a strike. No balls and one strike on T.J. Mittelstadt. Explorers coming into tonight's game on a three-game winning streak, but trailing 7-1 here in the sixth inning. The 0-1 delivery in the dirt, blocked by Coach. So that evens it up at one ball and one strike on T.J. Mittelstadt. And home plate umpire Scott Shores will throw that ball out of play. Infield double play depth, LaRoche at first. Nobody out, one ball, one strike. High and outside, and now it's 2-1. Matt Coach will call time and go out and have a quick visit with Billy Bullock. Wichita has been a better club on the road than they have been at home this year. They have won 27 and lost 20 on the road, 27 and 17. So there's not too much difference between their home record and their road record. High for a ball, and now it's 3-1. However, Wichita against teams in the Central Division, they are 8-11. 54-37 overall record for the Wingnuts. 3-1 pitch. Outside, ball four, and Mittelstadt is walked. So back-to-back walks to start the sixth inning. Third walk given up by Bullock. Nobody out. And now Harrison Kane coming up. Kane has doubled, scored a run in three at-bats. He's also flied to right field, and he's flied to center. Bats with nobody out here in the sixth inning, and Wichita leading 7-1. Runners first and second, nobody out. And a strike to the right-handed hitting Harrison Kane. Kane's double back in the second inning. It's been his only hit in this series. One for three tonight. One for nine in the series, right-handed hitter. There's a ground ball toward shortstop. Perillo will go on to first to get the out. The ball was hit slowly, and Perillo had to charge it on the grass part of the infield. And on the play, LaRoche moves on over to third. And to second base goes Middlestad. So Kane is out 6-3, short to first. That's the first out here in the sixth inning, and it will bring up Brent Dean. Dean tonight has singled and doubled in three at-bats. Last time up, popped up to second base. Tassoni playing second base tonight. He made the catch in shallow right center field. Dean, right-handed hitter. Explorers will bring their infield not quite all the way to the edge of the grass, but in some. And the pitch almost hit him. It did. Caught him on the left sleeve. And Dean down to first base being hit by a pitch, and that loads the bases with one out. So Dean has been hit by a pitch. So the bases are loaded for Leo Vargas. Vargas has had a couple of hits this evening. A couple of singles. He's 2-for-3 with a run scored. So Wichita with the bases loaded and one out here in the sixth inning. They're already leading 7-1. Bullock ready. Here's the ball hit back to the mound. Bullock will come to the plate and almost threw it away. Coach had to reach down and get it. If it had been a good throw, they had a chance of getting a double play. They get the out at home on LaRoche. It'll go 1-2 on the put out. That's the second out of the inning. Middlestad moves on over to third. Dean to second base. And Vargas is at first on the fielder's choice. So the bases are still loaded, but now with two outs. And Taylor Smart has been safe on an error. He has singled, driven in a run, scored a run. Also had a sacrifice bunt. Lines one foul down toward the bullpen of Wichita down in the right field corner. And it's strike one. No balls and one strike on Taylor Smart. Wichita with the bases loaded and two out here in the sixth inning. Wichita leading 7-1 over the Explorers. Middlestad at third, Dean at second, Vargas at first. Bullock on the mound with the pitch. In there for a strike with a fastball. And it's no balls and two strikes on Taylor Smart, who is the number nine hitter in the batting order for Wichita. No balls and two strikes on Smart. The 0-2 pitch. Did he go or not? And he did on a check swing, and the inning is over as Smart strikes out swinging on a check third strike. Bullock gets his first strikeout here in the sixth inning for Wichita. No runs, no hits, no errors, and they leave three runners stranded. After 5.5 innings, it's now Wichita 7 and the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KLCJ.
Register today and every day, but make sure you're at Arena Vegas every Tuesday and Thursday in June and July to have a free chance to play in the Grand Slam Slot Tournament. Why go anywhere else when you can play for a share of $350,000 for free at Winna Vegas Casino Resort?
Wouldn't you rather win?
529 to exit 127, Sloan, Iowa.
Your 2015 Central Division champion, Sioux City Explorers, are gearing up for an American Association championship run, and they invite you to be a part of the excitement and all the action. The Explorers will host the American Association semifinal series, game 1 and 2 at Lewis and Clark Park, Wednesday, September 9th and Thursday, September 10th. Playoff tickets are on sale now at the Lewis and Clark Park ticket office or by calling 277-WINS.
Now coming to the plate, number 9, Renee Tassoni.
Bottom of the sixth inning, Rene Tassoni will lead it off for the Explorers. He's 0 for 2 tonight and struck out and fly to center field. Tassoni, Kelgard, and Perillo to bat here in the bottom of the sixth inning, with Wichita leading 7-1, and Scott Richmond on the mound to start his sixth inning of work. And he misses down low for ball one. We continue our fan appreciation week. Close it out tomorrow night, 7:05 game time. The Explorers and Wichita. And our fan appreciation week, $1 can and draft beer, $1 Pepsi fountain drinks, and 25 cent hot dogs through tomorrow night. Here's a line drive, one hop. First baseman on the short hop, LaRoche will take it. Step on the bag, and that's the first out here in the sixth inning. One out in the sixth for Brock Kelgard, who is 2 for 2 tonight. Singled in the second has supplied the Explorers' only run with a solo home run in the fourth inning, his 14th of the season. Bats with one out here in the sixth inning. Scott Richmond has given up 6 hits through the first 5 and a third innings. Kelgard takes the breaking pitch down and away in the dirt for ball one. Again, tomorrow night is the final regular season home game for the Explorers. 7:05 tomorrow night. Fireworks after the game. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Misses outside, and it's 2-0. Two balls and no strikes. Clay Kilgard straight away in the outfield. Batting with one out here in the sixth. Richmond started to go to the windup and then backed off, and wants another set of signs from his catcher, Brent Dean. Two balls, no strikes on Kelgard. Fouls it straight back to the backstop, and it's 2 balls and 1 strike. Left-hander Ryan Struthing will get the start tomorrow night in the final regular season home game for the Explorers. Right-hander Tim Brown. He is 9-2 on the season. He'll pitch tomorrow night for Wichita. Breaking pitch, strike two. Good sharp breaking pitch by Richmond. It evens up the count at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Struthing is 1-3 on the season. He'll pitch tomorrow night. 2-2 pitch, grounded foul past third, and it stays 2 balls and 2 strikes. It'll be Struthing the left-hander against Brown the right-hander. The season finale for regular season home games. The Explorers, of course, will be back here on September the 9th and 10th for the first 2 games of the American Association playoffs. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Swing and a miss. That pitch about 1.5 feet, 2 feet out of the strike zone. Kelgard strikes out swinging. That's the second out here in the sixth inning. That's the 5th strikeout for Richmond. So 2 out here in the bottom of the sixth inning for Noah Perea, who's had a base hit, and he's also hit into a double play. He is 1 for 2. So Perea will bat. 2 out, nobody on here in the sixth inning. Playoff tickets are available by contacting the Explorers office, or you can come by it here at the ballpark. There's a strike on outside part of the plate to the left-handed hitting for Rio, and it's no balls and one strike. Flores will be hosting the first two games of the American Association playoffs. Strike two on the outside part, same spot. And it's no balls, two strikes on Perillo. The playoffs are the best 3 out of 5. More than likely, the Explorers against St. Paul. There's strike three on a breaking pitch, and the inning is over. Three pitches, and Perillo caught looking. That's the sixth strikeout for Richmond. And the Explorers down in order here in the sixth inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left. Our score after six innings, it's Wichita 7 and the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. Top of the seventh inning, it'll be the top of the batting order. Nick Van Stratton will lead it off as Billy Bullock will start his third inning of relief work here in the seventh. And he misses high with a breaking pitch for ball one. Van Stratton has had a base hit in three at-bats. He's also walked. Had an RBI single in the fourth inning and then later scored. 1-0 pitch. A strike on the inside corner, and it's one ball and one strike. Five runs, or make it seven runs on 12 hits tonight for Wichita. Did he go or not? He did not, as he checked his swing. And it's two balls and one strike. The Explorers have one run on 6 hits tonight. The Explorers have committed a couple of errors. Two balls and one strike on Van Stratton. Breaking pitch, a good one. Strike two. Nice, sharp breaking pitch by Bullock. And it evens it up at two balls and two strikes. Top of the batting order, Nick Van Stratton leading it off here in the seventh inning. 2-2 pitch. Line drive, left field, coming in, and Keyes makes the catch about belt high. That's the first out here in the seventh inning. So Bullock pitching here in the third inning that he has pitched in. He went 4 innings on June the 27th against Amarillo, so this is his second longest outing of the year. For John Straka, the starter, went only 4 innings tonight. Pitch is taken for a strike by Jace Ray, who's had a couple of hits, 2 for 4. And an RBI scored a run. Left-handed hitter, Jace Ray, batting with one out, nobody on, in the top of the seventh inning. Line drive, base hit left field. So Ray gets his third hit of the game. And that's the 13th hit for Wichita. to Ray at first base with one out. And now Brent Cleveland will come up. Cleveland has had a double and an RBI, three at-bats. He has struck out and popped the first, the other two at-bats. Right at it, hitter is Cleveland. It's a 7-1 lead for Wichita. We're in the top of the seventh inning. Infield, double play depth. Cleveland, right at it hitter. Now he asks and steps out of the batter's box, gets time. From the home plate umpire, Scott Shores. So Ray at first base, one out here in the seventh. Bullock, the stretch, and the breaking pitch is in for a strike. Around the American Association tonight, Fargo Moorhead has beaten Winnipeg. That final is now 11-4. Fargo the winner. Broken bat toward first base. Up with it. Patron will go to second and out at second base. Now the throw back to first and safe at first base. Oh, the bat was flying everywhere. Patron picked it up, picked up the ball and threw to second base to Perillo, and he almost overthrew Perillo. Now the barrel of the bat is out toward third. The handle of the bat probably disintegrated. So Ray is out at second base. It'll go 3-6 on the putout with the shortstop covering. That's the second out of the inning. So Cleveland is at first base on the fielder's choice, and the cleanup hitter is Andy LaRoche. 0-3 with a walk tonight. Bats with two out here in the seventh. And the breaking pitch is a little high and inside for ball one. So Fargo Moorhead beats Winnipeg 11-4. That at Winnipeg. 1-0 pitch, taken for a strike. Laredo has defeated Amarillo 8-3, so it kind of solidifies their lead as far as the wild card is concerned. One ball, one strike. Fouled straight back and out of play. So it's one ball and two strikes on LaRoche. Also around the league tonight, Sioux Falls shut out Lincoln 5-0. New Jersey leading Gary 4-0 in the fourth was the latest report we had on that one. Grand Prairie and Joplin are tied at 2-2 in the seventh. Pitch high and outside, and it's two balls and two strikes. And St. Paul is leading Kansas City 3-1 there in the bottom of the eighth inning at Kansas City. Second chip to date on the American Association scoreboard on this Saturday. Here it's 7-1. Wichita leading the Explorers. Two balls and two strikes on LaRoche. Low and inside, and now it's gone full at 3-2. So the runner at first base, Cleveland, will be off and running with this pitch. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Bullock in his third inning of relief for the Explorers. John Strotka, the starter, went only four innings tonight. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. The pitch, line drive, center field, and it's going to be in there for extra bases. It's going to go all the way to the fence. Cleveland around third. He will score easily, and stopping at second with a double is LaRoche, and it's now 8-1. In favor of Wichita. On a 3-2 pitch, Cleveland was off and running. He scored easily on the double by LaRoche, driving in his 17th run of the year. That's his first hit of the night. That is the 14th hit for Wichita. And they now lead it 8-1 here in the seventh inning. With two outs, T.J. Middleston has walked twice. He's been on base all four times tonight. He had the home run in the second, a double in the third. Takes it high and outside for ball one. One ball to no strikes on T.J. Middleston. He walked in the fourth, walked in the sixth. One ball and no strikes on the left-handed hitter. Takes a strike to the letters. And it's one ball and one strike. Wichita scored two runs in the second, five in the fourth. They've added another run here in the seventh inning and lead it 8-1. Runner at second base, LaRoche with two out. 1-1 pitch is fouled off to the third base side out of the ballpark. And it's one ball and two strikes. 7:05 game time tomorrow night. Fireworks after the game here at Lewis and Clark Park tomorrow night. That'll be the final regular season game of the year for the Explorers before the playoffs begin on September the 9th. One ball and two strikes on Mittelstadt. Down low, breaking pitch missed, and it's 2-2. Explorers will be on the road all next week. Starting on Tuesday night, four-game series at Grand Prairie, and then on to South Texas to Laredo to close out the regular season. Down low, and now it's full count, 3-2. So the Explorers will have seven regular season games left, all on the road starting on Tuesday. Four at Grand Prairie and three at Laredo. Three balls, two strikes on Mittelstadt. 3-2 pitch. Inside, and Mittelstadt has walked for the third time. He's been on base all five times tonight. That's the fourth walk given up by Bullock. That puts runners at first and second with two out for Harrison Kane. Kane has doubled in four at bats and has scored a run. Bullock in his third inning of relief. He came on in the fifth. Two out here in the seventh. And a foul straight back for strike one. No balls and one strike on Harrison Kane. Matty Johnson in center, shading the right-handed inning Kane toward right center field. Key straight away and left, the same with Lang in right field. 0-1 pitch. Chopped foul off the third base side. We'll roll down toward the Explorers bullpen, who we'll get some activity going in that bullpen now. Rob Ward is the one that's throwing down to the bullpen for the Explorers. It's an 8-1 lead for Wichita here in the seventh. No balls, two strikes on Kane. High and outside. And it's one ball, two strikes. Well, Wichita was held in check last night, but they have turned it around on the Explorers here this evening. They had only eight hits in the doubleheader last night. Fouled out of play to the right, and it stays one ball, two strikes. But tonight, the Wingnuts have pounded out 14 hits, and we're in the seventh inning, and they have an 8-1 lead over the Explorers. One ball, two strikes on Harrison Kane. Bullock ready with the pitch. Hit down the right field line, but it's twisting and out of play down into the Wichita bullpen. Lang gave chase, but he ran out of room. So it stays one ball and two strikes. So Rob Wirt beginning to throw in the Explorers bullpen. Second longest outing of the year for Billy Bullock. One ball, two strikes here on Kane. The stretch and the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. And the inning is over. Bullock gets his second strikeout as Kane strikes out for the final out in the seventh. In the seventh inning, Wichita scores one run. They do it with two hits. There was no errors. And they leave two runners on base. Time now for the seventh inning stretch. Brought to you by Interstate Batteries. They're outrageously dependable. We go to the bottom of the seventh inning. Wichita 8 and the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSEJ.
We want to make sure where you're going remains worth getting to. Interstate Battery, the nation's number one car battery replacement.
Liberty National Bank is not just a voice on the phone. We are part of your community and committed to making your banking as easy as possible. We are a full-service bank of friendly, experienced professionals that serve you at locations in Sioux City, Dakota Union, Paxton, Jefferson, North Sioux City, Sioux Falls, and Okoboji. For more information about our products and services, please call us at any one of our branches or go to our website, libertynationalonline.com. Member FDIC.
Your 2015 Central Division Champion, Sioux City, is preparing up for an American Association Championship run, and they invite you to be a part of the excitement and all the action. The Explorers will host the American Association Semifinal Series Game 1 and 2 at Lewis and Clark Park, Wednesday, September 9th and Thursday, September 10th. Playoff tickets are on sale now at the Lewis and Clark Park ticket office or by calling 277-WINS. Be a part of the playoff.
Tommy Mendoza leading it off here in the seventh. One ball, one strike on Mendoza, who struck out twice tonight. Was called out on strikes in the second inning. Struck out swinging in the fourth. Down low as Richmond misses. And it's two balls and one strike. Mendoza, coach, and patron. Well, bat here in the bottom of the seventh inning as the Explorers trail 8-1. Two balls and a strike on Tommy Mendoza. Takes it high, and now it's 3-1. Three balls, one strike on Mendoza, who came into the game on a four-game hitting streak. 3-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Now it's a full count at 3-2. Three balls, two strikes. Richmond has given up six hits, one run, hasn't walked anybody, has struck out six tonight. Make it strikeout number seven. Mendoza caught looking as he strikes out for the third time. That's seven strikeouts for Richmond. Everything he threw Mendoza in that at-bat and the other two at-bats have been away, and Mendoza called out on strikes. One out for Matt Coach, who has had a two-for-two night. Singled in the third, doubled in the fourth. So Coach bats with one out. Hits it in the air to center field. Van Stratton going back, still going back, still going back, and near the warning track will pull it down for the second out here in the seventh inning. Coach gave it a pretty good ride to center field, but Van Stratton got back there to make the play on it. So there's two out for Eno Patron. Patron 0-for-2 has flied to center and grounded to second. So Eno Patron playing first base tonight. Activated today, making it 23 on the roster for the Explorers, which is the league limit. 10 days before the season's end. Patron, left-handed hitter. Lifts a foul. That will be out of play off the third base side, and it's strike one. No balls and one strike. Wichita getting some activity going in their bullpen. Their bullpen is kind of short. I think they only have like eight total pitchers. There's a foul down the left field line, down toward the Explorers bullpen. And it's no balls, two strikes on Patron. Brad Orsi is the one throwing in the bullpen for Wichita. Outside from Richmond. And it's one ball and two strikes. 8-1 lead for Wichita here in the seventh inning over the Explorers. Richmond's 1-2 pitch down low, and it's 2 balls, 2 strikes. Seven innings is about the limit for Richmond. He went to 7 1/3 innings his last time out. Working here in the seventh inning with 2 out. 2 balls, 2 strikes on Patron. Richmond, who spent parts of 3 or 4 seasons in the big leagues with the Toronto Blue Jays, kind of off and on. Fouled it off, left of home plate. And it stays, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Richmond started out his career in the Northern League, back when it was in existence, with Edmonton. Spent 3 years at Edmonton. He's from Canada, from Vancouver. 2-2 pitch. Bounce foul again. That hit off Patron's foot, bounced off to the left, almost in the same spot. And it stays, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Last affiliated pitching for Richmond was last year with Round Rock, the Rangers AAA team, Pacific Coast League, outside, and now it's going full at 3-2. 3 balls and 2 strikes on Patron, batting with 2 out, nobody on base here at the bottom of the seventh inning. 3-2 pitch. Line towards center, but Van Stratton is right there to make the catch, and that's all for the Explorers here in the seventh inning. Up and down in order. Matter of fact, 3 consecutive innings that Richmond has thrown up shutout innings against the Explorers, and 9 straight or 10 straight, he is now retired. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left. Our score after 7, it's Wichita 8 and the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. New pitcher for the Explorers is going to be Rob Wart. Will come on to pitch here in the eighth inning. Bullock goes 3 innings, 2 hits, 1 run, 4 walks, 2 strikeouts, and he hit a batter. So Rob Wart comes on here in the eighth inning. This is his 38th relief appearance of the season. He's appeared in more games than any other Explorer pitcher. 9 wins, 3 losses out of the bullpen for Rob Wart, with 4 saves and a 2.02 earned run average. And a fastball is in for a strike. His last appearance was against Gary on Wednesday. So Rob Wart is the third pitcher the Explorers have used, as Brent Dean leading it off here in the eighth. Ward misses outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Dean has had a couple of hits tonight. A single, a double. He has driven in a run. He has scored a run. He was hit by a pitch his last time up in the sixth inning. Leads it off here in the top of the eighth for Wichita. Swing and a miss. And it's strike two. Tonight's attendance here at Lewis and Clark Park, 2,867 on this Saturday night. Hope to see you out here tomorrow night for the final regular season home game for the Explorers, 7:05 against Wichita with fireworks after the game. 1-2 pitch, fouled it back, and it stays one ball and two strikes. Bottom third of the batting order for Wichita here in the eighth inning. Dean, Vargas, and Smart. It's the third pitcher the Explorers used tonight. John Strotka started, but only went four innings. Bullock in the fifth, he pitched three innings in relief, and now Rob Ward here in the eighth. One ball, two strikes. Swing and a miss. Down goes Dean. And that's the first out here in the eighth inning. One out in the eighth for Leo Vargas. Vargas has had two hit night. A couple of singles and a run scored in four at bats. He's 2-for-4 tonight, right-handed hitter. Rob Wart, the right-hander on the mound for the Explorers, in relief here in the eighth inning. Vargas takes strike one. No balls and one strike on Vargas. Wart works out of the stretch. And a breaking pitch that missed down low. And it's one ball and one strike. The big fourth inning tonight for Wichita when they scored five runs. They sent 10 batters to the plate in that fourth. They now lead it 8-1. Strike on the outside part of the plate. And it's one ball, two strikes on Vargas. Flores came into the game tonight on a three-game winning streak, but trailing 8-1 here in the eighth inning. One ball, two strikes. Ward to the plate. Fisted foul. Green.
Richmond, 7 innings, 6 hits.
We'll get a new pitcher for Wichita here in the eighth inning. It's going to be Brad Orsi. So Orsi worked an inning last night in the first game of the doubleheader, gave up one hit, gave up a walk. So Orsi comes on to pitch here in the eighth inning. So the starter, Scott Richmond, 7 innings, 6 hits, 1 run. No walks and 7 strikeouts. Orsi, this is his 10th game to appear in with Wichita. No wins, 2 losses. 372 earned run average. 9 2/3 innings with 6 strikeouts, 4 walks. So Brad Orsi comes on here in the 8th inning. And Brent Keyes will lead it off for the Explorers. Has had a double and 2 at-bats. Orsi misses high for ball one. Keyes doubled in the fourth last time up, grounded out to first base unassisted. That was in the fifth inning. And now it's 2 balls and 0 strikes. Two balls, no strikes on Brent Keyes, leading off here in the eighth. Fouls it back up into the seats off third. It's 2 balls and 1 strike. Orsi signed with Wichita on August the 10th. pitching at Normal, Illinois in the Frontier League. Another foul out of play to the left side. He appeared in three games with Fargo-Moorhead. Has not been with an affiliated team. He's been in the Pecos League, the United League. There's a fastball, strike three call. Keys caught looking for the first out. Here in the eighth inning. That is eight strikeouts tonight for Wichita pitcher. Pitched at Alpine in the Pecos League, Rio Grande Valley in the United League. Fargo-Moorhead in the American Association, Rio Grande Valley again. And started out this season at Normal, Illinois, where he was 0-1 in three games that he appeared in, all as a starter. And he misses outside for ball one to Matty Johnson, who is 0-3 tonight. His fly to left, to center, and he struck out his last time up. Swing and a miss. Fastball by Morsi. Morsi, 5'11", 170-pound right-hander from Houston, Texas. Matty Johnson at the plate and takes it high and outside, and it's 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Michael Lang on deck. The Explorers trailing 8-1 here in the eighth inning. Hit down the left field side. Everybody giving chase, but it'll land out of play down toward the Explorers bullpen. And it evens it up with two balls and two strikes on Matty Johnson. Explorers in Wichita tomorrow night, 7:05. It's the final regular season home game for the Explorers. Hope you can make your plans to get out here tomorrow night. We'll have fireworks after the game. Two balls, two strikes on Johnson. 2-2 pitch. High and outside, and now it's going full at 3-2. Three balls, two strikes on Johnson. One out, nobody on. This one's hit in the air off the left side. Mittelstadt giving chase, but he'll run out of room as it lands just down beyond the seats down the third base side. So it remains a full count at three balls and two strikes. Broadcast tomorrow starts at 6:35 with our American Airlines pregame show. Hope you can make your plans to get out here on a Sunday night. Normally we start them at 6:05, but because of fireworks tomorrow night, we'll start it at 7:05. 3-2 pitch. Inside, and a walk to Matty Johnson. That's the first walk given up by Wichita pitching tonight. So it puts Matty Johnson at first with one out for Michael Lang, who's 0-3. Lang is lined to center. He's grounded to short and bounced to third. He has an 0-3 night. Now 2-8 in the series. Right-handed hitter with Johnson at first and one out. Morsi from the stretch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. No balls and one strike on Lang. Bottom of the eighth inning here at Lewis and Clark Park. 8-1 lead for Wichita. Pitches high, and it's a ball and a strike. Wichita has never trailed in this game. They led 2-0 in the second inning. Started off with a leadoff home run by Mittelstadt in that second. Pitch is popped up. Coming back is Dean, but it's going to land up into the seats. Behind home plate, about five or six rows. And it's one ball, two strikes on Michael Lang. The big inning tonight, like it was last night, but last night it was the Explorers getting the big inning, but tonight it's been Wichita. Five runs in the fourth inning. They now lead it 8-1 here in the eighth. One ball, two strikes on Lang. Takes it high, and it's 2-2. One out walk to Matty Johnson. He's at first. Lang at the plate with one out with Tosoni on deck. Brad Orsi in relief of Scott Richmond, who went the first seven innings for Wichita. So Richmond is the pitcher of record right now for Wichita. Two balls and two strikes on Michael Lang. Orsi to the plate. Strike three call, and Lang has caught looking. That's the second strikeout for Orsi. That is nine strikeouts recorded tonight by Wichita pitching. So two out for Renee Tosoni, is hitless in three at-bats. Has struck out, flied to center, and grounded to first. So Tosoni will bat with two out and Johnson at first. And he takes strike one. Nine strikeouts posted tonight by Wichita pitching. Five of those nine have been on called third strikes. Hit towards center field. Back on it goes Van Staten. Still going back. Now settling under it. It makes the catch. And that's all for the Explorers here in the eighth inning. No runs in the inning. There were no hits, no errors. A walk, one left. We've completed eight. It remains Wichita eight. And the Explorers won. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ.
Time to get those 50-50 raffle tickets out, fans. The next prize is $143.
We go to the top of the ninth inning. A new pitcher for the Explorers is going to be right-hander Jose Flores, appearing in his 34th game, all in relief. One win, one loss, 20 saves. Just trying to get a little work in here tonight. Last time the pitch was on Wednesday. Picked up his 20th save on Wednesday night against Gary, win an inning. Struck out one, walked one, no hits, no runs. So Flores will come on to work here in the ninth. Rob Ward, one inning, no hits, no runs, a walk, two strikeouts. Jace Ray will lead it off for Wichita here in the top of the ninth inning. Flores misses outside for ball one. Ray, Cleveland, and LaRoche to bat here in the ninth inning for Wichita. A 1-0 pitch taken for a strike, and it's one ball and one strike. Flores is the fourth pitcher the Explorers have used tonight. Strotka has started, went four innings. Bullock pitched three innings, worked the eighth, and now Flores here in the ninth. The 1-1 pitch coming. Popped up in the infield. Who's going to call for it? Tosoni, Perillo. over where right in front of Pisoni at second base and made the catch for the first down. One out here in the ninth inning. Brent Cleveland has had a double tonight in four at bats and has driven in a run, and he's also scored a run. Right-handed hitter is Cleveland. One out here in the top of the ninth inning. Flores to Cleveland. Inside for ball one. Andy LaRoche on deck. We have one out here in the top of the ninth inning. 8-1 lead for Wichita. Swing and a miss. And it's a ball and a strike on Cleveland. Wichita came into the game in first place in the South Division. They're trying to wrap up our playoff spot. Four-game lead over Laredo coming in to play tonight. Ball and a strike on Cleveland. Good breaking pitch. Off speed, got it over. Strike two. Good pitch by Flores. One ball and two strikes on Brent Cleveland. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Fouled over the screen and out of the park. To our right. And it's a ball and two strikes. Flores will go on the road after tomorrow night to close out the regular season. Grand Prairie for four starting on Tuesday and then to Laredo for three. Next Saturday through Monday, Labor Day. Swing and a foul tipped, and that hit Coach. He pops up, though. He wasn't able to hang on to it. Limping a little bit now as he walks back behind the plate. His catchers do take a beating. So it stays one ball and two strikes on Cleveland. One out here in the top of the ninth inning. Flores won the first two games of this series, a doubleheader here last night, but Wichita is turning the tables on the Explorers tonight with 14 hits. Inside corner, strike three call. Cleveland can't believe it. And that's the second out of the inning. Two out here in the ninth. That is seven strikeouts for Explorers pitchers. So we have two out in the ninth for Andy LaRoche. LaRoche is 1-for-4. He had an RBI double his last time up in the seventh inning. He's also walked tonight. Batting in the cleanup spot, right-handed hitter. Up and in with a fastball for ball one. One ball and no strikes. Flores pitching here in the ninth inning. 1-0 pitch. Inside and high, and it's 2-0. Two out, nobody on. Top of the ninth inning. Wichita with the 8-1 lead over the Explorers. Two balls and no strikes on LaRoche. The 2-0 pitch, fouled right over our heads and out of the park. And it's two balls and a strike. Brian Struffing tomorrow night for the Explorers in the finale of this four-game series. Left-hander with a record of 1-3. Right-hander Tim Brown, 9-2 on the year, will pitch tomorrow night for Wichita. The 2-1 delivery, down low. And now it's going to three balls and a strike on LaRoche. Just a very light breeze here at the ballpark here on this Saturday evening. Flores, 3-1 pitch. Strike two call on the inside corner. Roach had tossed the bat in the air. He was headed toward first base, but home plate umpire Scott Shores had other ideas about it. Now it's a full count at 3-2. With two outs and nobody on base. Torres with a 3-2 pitch. Low ball four.
Where's that at? That is not down. No, it's not down.
So that shows me now that Wichita has had a base runner in every inning tonight. Two out walk here in the ninth inning. For T.J. Mittelstadt, who has been on base all five times tonight. He had a home run in the second inning, his 15th of the year, doubled in the third, and has walked his last three times up. That's with two out and a runner at first here in the ninth. Down low for ball one. One ball and no strikes on Mittelstadt. Runner at first base is LaRoche with two out. Mittelstadt, left-handed hitter. Flores, the right-hander on the hill, to the plate. Taken for a strike, and it's 1-1. One ball and one strike on the Wichita third baseman, T.J. Mittelstadt. 15 home runs this year, ties him for fifth in the league in the home run department. Flores with a 1-1 pitch. Hit toward left field, coming in. Keys is there and makes the catch, and the inning is over. In the ninth inning, no runs, no hits, no errors, and one left. We go to the bottom of the ninth. Our score, it's Wichita 8 and the Explorers 1. You're listening to Explorers Baseball on KSCJ. A new pitcher for Wichita as we go to the ninth inning. It's going to be right-hander Paul Smythe will come on to pitch here in the ninth inning. He's appearing in his eighth game with a record of one win, no losses, five saves, and a 129 earned run average. So Paul Smythe on here in the ninth inning. 5'11", 210-pound right-hander. Makes his home in Lawrence, Kansas. Started out this season in the Atlantic League at Somerset. Played his college baseball at the University of Kansas. He was selected in the 35th round by Oakland in 2009. Began this season, he made 28 appearances for the Somerset Patriots in the Atlantic League. Brock Kelgard will lead it off for the Explorers. Here in the bottom of the ninth inning, Explorers trail it 8-1. So Smythe set, and a fastball in there for strike one. No balls and one strike. Kelgard, Perillo, and Mendoza. We'll bat here in the bottom of the ninth inning for the Explorers. Smythe, sidearm delivery, check swing, foul, and it's strike two. Horsey went one inning. No hits, no runs with a walk and two strikeouts. So Smythe is the third pitcher that Wichita has used tonight. Smythe on here in the ninth. No balls, two strikes on Kelgard. Here's the pitch. It misses outside for a ball. Kelgard has supplied the only run for the Explorers tonight. He had a solo home run in the fourth inning. It was his 14th of the year. He's had a couple of hits. He's 2 for 3. Leads it off here in the ninth. And he just got hit by a pitch. Caught him right in the side. So Kelgard will toss the bat away and hit on down to first base. Hit by a pitch. Here to lead it off in the ninth. Noah Perillo will come up. He has had a base hit tonight. He's 1 for 3. Left-handed hitter with Kelgard at first base. Being hit by a pitch to start the bottom of the ninth. Perillo had a single in the fourth. He struck out in the sixth, was called out on strikes. Hit into a double play back in the second inning. Kelgard not being held at first. LaRoche playing behind him at first base. And Smythe misses high for ball one. One ball and no strikes on Noah Perillo. Smythe stops at the belt, the pitch outside, and it's 2-0. Two balls and no strikes. Well, the Explorers scored 9 runs in the fifth inning last night. Need that tonight, here in the ninth. Trailing 8-1. And the pitch. High ball 3. One thing about it, you can't hit a 9-run home run. You just got to do your best and try to get some base runners on and a few base hits and see what you can do. Never over till you get the 27th out. Three balls and no strikes on Perillo. Kelgard at first. Smythe, 3-0 pitch. In there for a strike right down the heart of the plate. Then it's 3 balls and 1 strike. Brewers have had just 6 hits tonight off 3 different pitchers that Wichita has used. Scott Richmond was the starter. He went 7 innings. 3-1 delivery. Fouled it off. Rolled it toward the Explorers' third base dugout. Now it's a full count at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Full count. 3-2 on Perillo. Kelgard. This casual walk is lead at first. And the full count to Perillo. Swing and a miss. Perillo strikes out. So Smythe came back from down in the count at 3-0 and comes back and strikes out Perillo for the first out. Here in the ninth inning. That is 10 strikeouts recorded by Wichita pitching. Well, Tommy taking the collar tonight. He's 0-for-3 and he has struck out all 3 times. Twice on a called third strike and the other time on a swinging third strike. Kelgard at first. Mendoza looks at a strike at the letters. And it's no balls, 1 strike on Tommy Mendoza. We're in the bottom of the ninth inning. 8-1 lead for Wichita. Mendoza slightly open stance. Kelgard at first. One out. Laid off of it, but it's in there for a strike. And it's no balls, 2 strikes on Mendoza. No balls, two strikes on Tommy Mendoza with one out here in the ninth inning. Paul Smythe in relief with the 0-2 pitch. Ground ball towards shortstop. Flipping to second out there. Back to first. The double play, and this one is over as Mendoza hits into a double play. And that will do it for the game, and Wichita will win it, as that's the second double play that Wichita has turned tonight. Here in the ninth inning, the Explorers, no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left. Final score tonight, Wichita 8, the Explorers 1. I'll be back with totals, highlights, coming up next on KSCJ.
3 hours, 11 minutes.
Huh?
3:11.
Okay.